and rose from the dead, Christ got up from the dead, and the saints that appeared in Jerusalem when Christ rose from the dead, that was the first fruits. They were the first ones to go to heaven with a glorified body. Oh, this is so boring. Oh, all right. Now, the main harvest would be 1 Corinthians 15, 1 Thessalonians 4, when Christ will descend for the church, and all that are in Christ going to be what? Caught up to meet, and this will be the rapture, right? That's the main harvest. All right. Now, in the Old Testament, none of the Old Testament prophets talked about the main harvest. They didn't talk about the church, because even Daniel, in his revelation, Daniel didn't even say anything about the church. Right? He said Christ will be cut off. Then he went from there. He talked about, you know, I don't want to sound too scholarly, because y'all said, Pastor, he just talk all this stuff. He's just too hard to understand. Okay, Daniel didn't take that thing. Don't follow them. When Jesus died, then he said, Titus is going to come and will destroy Jerusalem, and the people are going to be what? Scattered all over the world. Then he jumped from that point to what? The last 7 years, which is the tribulation. He saw it all. And he talked about Jesus coming in cloud. But he was talking about at the end of the what? Tribulation period, when Christ would come back for the gleanings. The gleanings would be the people that have died during the what? Tribulation period, that what? Did not take the mark of the beast, who did not deny the name of Christ, and they were slain for the sake of the gospel, and they were, amen, they were the people that were what? In Revelation 24, amen, that was resurrected, amen, and they were a part of that what? Last group that got up, amen, when Christ came back to the earth to reign during that 1,000 years. Amen. So the church got up, amen, went up when, amen, at the head of the tribulation period, right? But at the end of the tribulation period, then you have the gleanings. Amen. That's going to be what? The people that died during the tribulation that were killed. Praise God. And you're going to have Israel, dead Israel, that didn't come out of the grave when Jesus rose from it. All the dead Israel is going to come for them. Now, I can prove that in about 4 scriptures. So the Lord just showed me the order in which people are going to be what? Resurrected, and they're going to be judged. You know that blessed me? That blessed me the end. The end. Now, how many believe that Daniel had it going on? Was he faithful?
Yeah.
All right, now I'm going to have to read that. She has it. Well, you know, we got the end, but I promise you the faithfulness part, I wish I could have time just to show all of the components that contributed to the great revelation that Daniel had. I know it works, because I'm no Daniel, but I'm getting it. I'm getting little by little. Amen. But if I employ the same discipline, the same work, virtue, develop the same virtue, then what? God is going to show it to the average person, just like he showed things to what? Daniel and the other prophets. How many can say amen? Hallelujah. Okay. Okay, now Daniel said, it said, then Daniel, verse 3, was preferred above the presidents and princes, because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king thought to set him over the whole realm. You know, he was the first president over 120 other presidents or princes. He was at the top. Every time Daniel obeyed God, he got a promotion. He always ended up being what? The top of the heap. Although he did not believe in the idolatry that all the others believed in. He believed in the true, okay? Then the presidents, and this is the last thing, and princes sought to find occasion against Daniel concerning the kingdom, but they could find none occasion nor fault, for as much as he was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him. Then said these men we shall fast any occasion. We shall not fast any occasion against this Daniel, except we find it against him concerning the law of his God. Amen. That's when they put a scheme into place, and as a result of that, Daniel was called praying. He was called praying. And as a result, that was a real what? That was how they got in through a technicality, because they made a law, and the king wasn't aware of the plot that they were trying to set for Daniel to try to get in, because he was not always praying to God three times a day. So Daniel ended up in the lion's den. But verse 22, my God has sent his angel and has shut the lion's mouth, that they have not heard me, for as much as before him innocency was found in me. And also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt. Then was the king exceeding glad, because the king was flooded. Those kings loved Daniel. Every king loved him. All right. Then the king was exceeding glad for him and commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found upon him, because he believed in his what? God. Amen. So he was faithful. To the end, he was faithful. How many can say amen? How many of those virtues are what God is calling for today? You can see many times why people are so stretched out, stressed and discouraged and messy. They can't get nowhere. Spiritual things don't mean nothing to them. Amen. I'm getting no amens now. But I believe that God wants us to come up. How many can say amen? We can get a lot more understanding than we pretend that we are capable of doing. Amen. All right, I'm through. God bless you. I want everybody to say praise the Lord. Say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All right, now the title of this message is called what? All right, I want you to leave with those six keys. All right, the first one we mentioned are what? All right, you got to be disciplined. Number two, persistent in prayer. And okay, number three, all right, faithfulness is one of them, because we just have to read that. All right, name another one. I didn't get to all of them. All right, another one, that he was not what? He did not seek vain glory. He was disinterested in power for personal glory. He gave all glory to God. Is that right? He did not seek what? Any type of personal glory. And let me see. I'll give you one more. It's going to take two sessions to do it. And he believed in God. You're right. He was developing faith. And the last one, if I am at point six, he had compassion for his people. What was going to happen to Israel in their last days? He was trying to find out the destiny that Israel would experience. He had compassion. That's the reason why he prayed 21 days. He prayed until that angel came and gave him understanding of what's going to happen to Israel in the latter years. All right, I'm done. Let's all say it. Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Yes.
Hallelujah!
Yes.
Hallelujah! All right, now, y'all are bearing through this hot weather, because after this hot weather is over, but what we're doing now, after this hot weather is over, we're going to have a time that we're going to set aside for the saints to start coming back and praying. Even for a couple of hours, they can come anytime in the evening they want to. Amen. We might just start a prayer meeting in the morning now, but we're going to do something different to inspire you to fasting and prayer. All right, but the thing I want you to do now, I want you to try to make Wednesday nights and all the handouts that we're giving you and all of the book on Thanksgiving is teaching you how to develop your faith and how to start praying the Word. This is the strongest way of developing your faith, at the same time develop your prayer life. All right, so I mean that's very powerful. It might not be important to you now, but you're going to realize, amen, how important it is to build the Word into your heart And whenever you pray, learn how to pray always in harmony with what God has already revealed. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we want everybody to raise your hand right now. 5 o'clock this evening, we're going to meet you back here. And we want you to make sure that you be here on time. Alright, I got a word to say to you after we terminate. Father, today, if there's any other that's not in my voice, want to say, Jesus, I understand that you desire me, my heart, my commitment, my dedication. And Jesus, I want to give my life to you because I know that you came that I might have life. That's the reason why you gave yourself the just for the unjust, just to bring us to God. Father, we ask today that you will move on the heart of every person that don't know Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Help them not say yes. Help them to realize that they can't make it. That their expectations will never be met. They will never experience eternity and eternity of peace and joy unless they make a commitment to turn to you today. Father, those of you, those in this place that's willing to make that commitment, willing to say yes, hallelujah, let them do it in boldness. For if they're ashamed to confess you before men, then you're going to be ashamed to confess them before the Father which is in heaven. Father, today we ask you to move on them now. If there's any that will say yes to you, let them show by the showing of their hands. Say, Jesus, I want to be saved. I want you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is there anybody that wants to give your life to the Lord? You want to make that commitment? Today is the day of salvation. Tomorrow is not promised. Behold, now is the accepted time. Would you like to have prayer here? Amen. You want to be saved or you're already saved? Amen. If you so, we'll be willing to pray with you. Amen. Just raise your hand wherever you are. Just raise your hand. Father, today, I receive you into my life as Lord and Savior. Believe that Jesus died for me, rose from the dead to set me free. And I make him the Lord of my life today. In Jesus' name we pray. Those that need strength, those that need healing, those that need deliverance. Father, your hand ain't short that it can't save. Neither your ear heavy that you can't hear. But when we turn to you, my people called by my name, humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked way, then you will hear from heaven. You'll forgive the land and you will begin to heal and bring them into that place of blessing. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Everybody just lift your hand in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for the word. Hey, thank you for a revelation of how to overcome and how to stay focused. Hallelujah. In these troubled times, we give you praise and glory now in Jesus' name. Everybody say it together. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. I'm just going to let you go. And now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost rest and abide with you now, henceforth, and forever. Everybody say it together. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.